Sometimes I get enough of having to listen to Nathan Oakley, Quantum Eraser, Widget Gets It, Tenth Man and the like in order to make my videos. So I decided to look at Quantum Eraser's website, globeterminator.com. I saw the same old nonsense there in the childish layout with the silly emojis and the stupid pubescent insults, but at least I wouldn't have to listen to the irritating voice of this self-proclaimed genius. He posted 7 of what he calls his flat earth proofs. In a series of 7 videos, I will pulverize each and every one of them. This is part 6, Coriolis effect. The pinnacle of Fluffo's misunderstandings is the Coriolis effect. The Coriolis effect, however, is very simple to understand. When an object connected to the Earth starts moving free from the surface of the Earth in a straight line over the rotating Earth, it deviates from that straight line as seen from an observer standing on the Earth. This deviation is zero when the object is moving due east or due west, and it is strongest when the object moves due north or due south. The deviation is caused by the difference in lateral speed of the object due to the conservation of momentum, that is, the lateral speed of the Earth at the point where the object has left the surface, and the changing lateral speed of Earth's surface along the trajectory of the object. Quantum Eraser starts off with: the necessary conditions for the Coriolis effect to exist are 2 different reference frames, the Earth, rotating reference frame, and the atmosphere, non-rotating coordinate system. This is, of course, his first and most important blunder that makes most, if not all, what he has to say after this moot. The atmosphere rotates with the Earth and therefore is not a different non-rotating reference frame. I'll get back to that later on. Most Fluffers want to approach this phenomenon from the reference frame side of it, but most Fluffers don't understand very much about reference frames at all. QE cites from www.norton.com a summary from the book Introduction to Ocean Sciences by Douglas E. Segar that gives a very shallow and inexact description of the phenomenon. The www.norton.com website is a publishing company that provides resumes of study books. The sentence that freely moving objects are not carried with the Earth as it rotates isn't quoted from the original book. It is quoted from one of the available resumes. As such, it cannot be considered a legitimate citation. It is a confusing statement, to say the least. Everybody knows that when you throw a ball on a moving car or out of the window of a moving car, that ball keeps on moving with the car. That's conservation of momentum at work, or even better, the law of inertia. Saying that the freely moving object, that is the ball, is not carried with the car is a misleading statement. It is not carried by the car anymore when it loses direct contact with the car, but it moves with the car at the same speed as the car because of conservation of momentum. Quantum Eraser murks the water a little more by stating that anything not tethered to the Earth is freely moving, suggesting that an object not tethered to the Earth has lost any influence of the Earth from the time it still was tethered to it. Now that he has imprinted this false claim about freely moving objects, he changes the topic. What's new with the Fluffer? And he comes up with the most ridiculous piece of nonsense you can hear from a Fluffer. He concludes from this false premise that a freely moving object is no longer carried by the Earth, that a flight from Charlotte, North Carolina to LA should, due to his free-moving principle, take around 1.5 hours. In reality, it's 4.5 hours. First of all, both places lie roughly on the same latitude. He says so himself. So this most certainly has nothing to do with the Coriolis effect. The Coriolis effect never takes place in directions due west or due east. Secondly, the plane, when taking off, takes with it the lateral speed of the Earth at that latitude and adds its own generated speed to that. This seems to be the greatest comprehension problem flurfers have. An object can be subject to different speeds at different directions. From a non-rotating reference frame, like in space, the plane looks like it's traveling at a lower speed flying westward and at a greater speed flying eastward. From the rotating reference frame, that is from the Earth itself, the plane will have the same speed flying in both directions. I said that the atmosphere rotates with the Earth, an explanation that Quantum Eraser doesn't accept, of course. He starts off by claiming that gases have no intermolecular bonds and begins a childish rant about Velcro, superglue and pixie dust. The guy obviously never heard of friction between solids and gases, never heard of drag, wind resistance, meteorites burning up at entering the atmosphere because of friction. So, the atmosphere is moving with the Earth. To make himself look even more stupid, he argues that ballers should explain different wind speeds moving in different directions simultaneously at different elevations in the atmosphere. Again, a demonstration of the complete ignorance of flurfers about the possibility of objects to move in different directions at different speeds at the same time. What he says about the atmosphere having to have ever-increasing tangential speeds with height is a clear demonstration that he doesn't understand simple geometry. At a height of 10 kilometers, the atmosphere would only have to have a lateral speed of 2.6 kilometers per hour more than it would have on the ground. That is next to nothing compared with the jet streams of over 100 kilometers per hour at that height. At the end, he comes back to the Coriolis effect, with the example of hurricanes rotating anti-clockwise in the northern hemisphere and clockwise in the southern hemisphere. And then he comes with another gem. The object acted by the Coriolis effect appears to deflect. In his eyes, that means that the object doesn't deflect at all, because in his eyes, to appear only means not being true. He conveniently ignores the other meaning of the word, come into sight, become visible. And the turning of the hurricanes becomes visible, as he shows himself on his website. He throws in a por favor, but it can't help him. He adds some more nonsense about the Foucault pendulum and repeats the same nonsense about the flight from Charlotte, North Carolina to LA. But I think we've had enough stupidity for the day. How stupid can anyone be? Oh well, it's just Quantum Eraser, who definitely has deserved his nickname, Questionable Education.